And so what we want is to build these system-level random testers as early as possible in the development process. And there are a number of reasons for this. First of all, what we'd like to do is start off with a simple version of our system that doesn't implement very much functionality, and then we want to use sort of a weak fuzzer. That is to say, we want to test it with values that are maybe perhaps not that interesting. And the good thing about this combination is these weak random tests probably are going to find some flaws, but what they're not going to do is flood our developers with huge numbers of bugs, like might happen if we used an extremely strong random tester. There's sort of no easier way to demoralize software developers than to hand them a really big pile of bugs. Nobody wants that. What they're going to start to do is ignore those bugs and get back to getting work done. What you want to do is give people a slow but steady stream of important bug reports and let them fix these as they go on. And there's another reason why it's nice to give people a continuous stream of bug reports, which is that what these do is they help show us flaws in our software. They help show us interfaces that we don't understand. They help show us modules that end up being extremely weak for one reason or another. And they basically help us better understand where our software development effort is going wrong. So now, if instead of giving people maybe a couple of bug reports a week for a year, we give them 100 bug reports at the very end, all they're going to do is triage to find the 5 most critical bugs and fix them using hacks. So nobody learns anything. Everybody's angry. Nobody's happy. Rather, what we'd like to have done is have been doing random testing all along and using it to spot weaknesses in our software. The other thing that happens is, as our software evolves to be more robust, as we move towards releasing it, we're evolving our random tester to be stronger and stronger. That is to say, maybe this week we had a feature where we generate a new kind of random input that we haven't generated before. And now this is going to generate some bug reports, and we'll fix them, and our software evolves to be more robust. If we keep doing this not just over weeks, but over years, what we'll end up with is a random tester and a system that have sort of gone through this co-evolution process where they've both become much stronger. That is to say, we've evolved an extremely sophisticated random tester, and we've also evolved a system that is robust with respect to the kind of faults that can be triggered by that random tester. And so what I firmly believe is, and of course I can't prove this, and you're free to disagree, is that if, for example, Microsoft had done this from the beginning, Adobe had done this from the beginning, and these other companies that end up with lots of security vulnerabilities had fuzzed their products all the way through the development chain, they'd end up with far fewer of these sort of nasty crashes and critical security vulnerabilities that they're always scrambling to patch, and that anybody with a fuzzer seems to be able to find without a whole lot of effort. Or at least that's been the case in the past. And it's possible now that with more widespread use of more aggressive fuzzers, that kind of era of easy security bugs in popular products maybe is hopefully starting to kind of tail off.